Welcome to the Guitar Channel. I am super happy to welcome you a new interview. I am with the one and only Dieter Rosberg in Mannheim, Germany. Dieter, how are you doing today?
Hi, I'm a little bit tired, a little bit exhausted, but totally happy.
Yeah,
totally.
I don't see why.
Why I'm exhausted,
yeah,
or happy?
Yeah.
You know, we here at the Guitar Summit in Mannheim, yeah, and it's an event especially made for guitar players and bass players. And we started working on this thing 2 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, you're working on a project for 2 years, and the closer it gets, the more work it is,
okay,
the more excited you are. And when you have 2 days over and you're on the last day, it finally settles down,
yeah,
a bit. I had a nice thing yesterday. My wife asked me, so how do you think it? How do you feel? How do you think? How is the show? I said, it's good. She said, you say only good? I said, yeah, sorry, but... It's true, it's great.
Before we go into detail about the Guitar Summit, tell us who you are and what you do for Guitar and Bass.
Yeah, my name is Dieter Rosberg, mm-hmm, as you said. I'm the editor-in-chief of Guitar and Bass, and we started the magazine 31 years ago.
Okay.
And I'm on board since then.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what we like.
Okay.
Talk about, write about guitars, basses, instrument, amplifiers,
mm-hmm,
everything.
Mm-hmm. And is that the first time Guitar und Bass is involved in such a huge event, or is that something you really wanted to pursue?
Yeah, actually, I was always thinking about doing such a thing, but we had like things like the Messe, we have,
yeah,
the NAMM shows,
mm-hmm,
and you know, lots of people in the industry came to us and said, we need something special for guitars,
yeah, mm-hmm,
and why don't you do it? This was a couple of years ago, and I always thought, should we do it?
Mm.
Isn't
that,
is that
our job, our mission?
Isn't that,
yeah,
our job? Isn't that a big risk? But the more we thought about it, the more came the idea, okay, I think we should do it.
Mm.
We try it.
Mm.
And then we talked to a lot of people. And one of the ideas with which you got to really do it is when the show, the Holy Grail Guitar Show in Berlin.
Yeah.
And this had happened 3 times. And I went there for the first time and I said, oh, that's cool.
This is working. Yeah.
This is working.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And they do it just for small guitar builders. Mm-hmm. So if they can do it and it works really good, we could do it too for a barbage. And the funny thing is that the people from who are running the Holy Grail Guitar Show, they're here too.
They have
a big booth here.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, actually we're friends.
Yeah,
we're,
yeah,
friends,
yeah,
and
yeah.
Everybody has the same idea.
Mm.
We have to do something for the business. We're a big community.
Mm.
And if we build up the community and everybody helps, then it's going to be good for everybody.
Yeah, yeah.
And, and you know, after on the third day now, I can say it worked.
Okay.
It worked.
Yeah, it's funny because it could seem paradoxical, because we you mostly probably saw the article on the Washington Post announcing the death of the electric guitar, and yet on the last 3 or 4 years we had the Holy Grail Guitar Show, we have here the Guitar Summit, and a lot of guitar events here and there, so that's definitely a good vibration, right?
It was such a funny thing, you know, nobody talked about or wrote about guitars, and then this article came out,
yeah,
and everybody, you know, all the newspapers said, oh, the guitar is dead,
yeah,
and we had some interviews in front of this show,
mm-hmm,
and I always said, no, it's not dead,
okay,
it's different. we don't gonna have a Hendrix again, we're gonna have someone different, it's gonna be other people. And actually we were thinking about calling this guy in Washington, come over and,
okay,
see the show and see that it's not dead.
You see so many dead people walking around, and you know, the zombie apocalypse of guitar is not,
yeah,
there yet.
You,
yeah,
know, and the other thing, it's not just a guitar show. We also have a lot of education stuff.
Yeah.
We have lots of workshops going on. We,
mm-hmm,
have at 6 o'clock at night, we had on Friday night, we had an acoustic guitar night,
mm-hmm,
2 or 3 hours. Yesterday we had an electric guitar night. And you know what? The big hall over there was filled. The people were there, and they liked handmade music from guitar players.
Yeah, yeah.
So, mm-hmm, I'm pretty sure it's not dead.
Mm.
And the other thing which we found out, because we're talking to people, we're making a little survey with the visitors, everybody's here is interested in guitars. You know, it's 100% target group, 100%.
Mm.
Everybody plays guitar, wants to play guitar, likes guitars, wants to learn something, wants to see something. So That's what I'm even more happy that that we got the news to the right people.
Okay, and it's you have to pay to get in the show, right? It's not an open
event. you have to pay an entrance fee, but it's, you know, if you pay it for one day, it's 18 euros.
Okay.
But you have the you can go to the show, you can see the workshops, and you can see the concerts.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we had on Friday night, we had a lot of people come in at 6 o'clock paying 80 euros for the concert.
So
then we thought, oh, maybe then we got it right, because then you see that it's that's this great idea. And we got some international musicians, we got German musicians, and especially on Friday we had John Gom, which is the acoustic guitar player in these days. And it was great.
Yeah.
Yesterday we had Guthrie Govan.
Yeah, yeah.
And
the workshop was full of people lining up to get in.
Right, right. And he played with the band yesterday night. We had some great, really great German guitar players, a German band, and then we had him playing with them. That was great.
Mm. Yeah, and there is a good mix regarding the exhibitors between big brands, small brands, medium brands, boutique builders, accessories and everything. How many exhibitors do you have here?
We have 130 exhibitors, and it's 300 brands.
Mm.
And we had, I think, 105 workshops and the two concert nights.
Yeah.
And there's another thing which is important to me, because I'm doing the Guitar and Bass magazine for such a long time. And the music always changed, and sometimes it's heavy, and sometimes it's jazz, and sometimes it's whatever. We always did a magazine for every guitar player. We never said we had the heavy metal guitar magazine or the whatever. We did it for everybody, and that's what we try to do with the show. We have guys playing ukulele here, a ukulele stand. We had a ukulele workshop yesterday.
Yeah,
you saw it.
Cool.
And but we also have guys who show how you play on a stick, or some other guy talking about the physics of guitar, or you have like Guthrie Govan who comes here and everybody wants to be in there.
Mm.
So it's a mixture, and we try to just cover everything for the guitar, not just one tiny little spot.
Yeah.
And I think this is the big thing which is good.
Mm-hmm.
A good friend of mine who used to be a TV producer and had TV shows with live music all the time, and he was here yesterday and he said, you know what, this was my dream for 10, 15 years to come to a show like this.
Okay.
I said, no, now we did it, now you're here and you're happy, and you know what, I'm happy too.
So this is the very first edition. I came here as an observer, because this is the first edition, so you don't know what to expect. And I really have to congratulate you, because the event is super well organized. Maybe not everything is perfect, but it doesn't feel like a first edition, you know. And maybe you German guys, are really good at organizing things. So kudos to you, because you did a great job, I think, on this one.
The funny thing is, we did it with our regular staff.
Okay.
The guys who work on the magazines, everybody helped. And we had just one additional guy hired who helps a little bit with the organization, but it was just the stuff doing the magazine. And we had a party yesterday night. We were going to grab a beer. We were five people, and we ended up with 40.
Okay.
Because people came in. We were sitting outside of next to this venue, outside in front of a hotel. And so one guy came up and said, you know what? We have the Frankfurt Musikmesse, which was always good in the old days, and it's really huge these days. I said, you know what? It's the feeling we had 20 years ago, but a little bit more modern.
Okay, nice.
I said, okay, then it's great, and it's like a big family, and everybody helps each other. Everyone is happy to see the other one. He said, we did a good job, and I said to everybody who's exhibiting here or is doing workshops, that we're part of it. You're part of it. We organized it, but you're part of it. But together we're strong.
Yeah.
It's not only this brand or we or this brand. It's together.
Yeah.
And and I think if we can keep up with this feeling, then it's going to be very good.
Mm. And the funny thing is that right behind me, there is a Musikmesse booth. So the Musikmesse is exhibiting at your show. That must feel good, right?
Yeah. Actually, we had a meeting about 9 months ago, and we told them about what we're doing.
Okay.
And actually, they asked us about doing that. They said, should we do magazines now because you're doing trade shows? said, no, we don't.
You want to fight?
And we said, no, we don't want to make a trade show like yours. We want to make a guitar event with lots of music and specialized on guitars. And after discussing it, they finally come and said, you know what, why don't we be your partner, like a sponsor?
Mm-hmm.
And said, it's good. Mm-hmm. So they're on every banner, and they help a little bit with promotion, and they have a booth.
Yeah.
It's good. Mm-hmm. It's better. Mm-hmm. We're not enemies. You know, it's actually we have this impression in Germany we're sitting in the same boat.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And have to fight that we don't. Yeah. that we don't.
Hopefully nobody is thinking. What do you think? What would you like to improve? I guess you're going to debrief after that, but what's the improvement you want to make?
There are a couple of. There's the EGB guys. Hi, Tanya. We have to do some organization stuff. For example, we're working with a partner here. The partner is actually it's the city of Mannheim. They own this place. They own this organization. They own a little startup company who's helping up with economy. And we have to do something on the booths. You know, we missed the numbers, for example. Mm-hmm. They used to have to be numbers. We have to be better signs. We have this. We haven't talked about this. We had one special thing. We try to make this show not noisy.
Yeah.
But we have one section which is loud,
where
you can play the amplifiers downstairs. Mm-hmm. Where you can check the amps and where you can mm-hmm. play loud. Mm-hmm. This is far away from here. Because we don't want to have it loud, but we have to make better signs that the people find it.
Cool, yeah.
A good thing is people come in here. It's not like a big hall, and they run around and after rounds said, "Oh, done. We go." You can look for something.
Yeah.
And I heard there's a room over there, and there's a room downstairs, and there's one upstairs. Mm. It's good because this is a funny place, though.
Yeah.
And but we had these are the things we have to improve. So we're going to work on the workshops a little bit more, and. On the other, everybody said, just leave it like it is.
Yeah. Well, I think you have a great formula as it is. And if I can make a suggestion, maybe it would be great to have some room to be able to try guitars and not just be able to play
Ola
with that phone.
Just Ola Eglund passing by. Just
yeah.
he's going to his workshop, which starts in 5 minutes.
So do you think it could be a good idea to have room to try the guitar and not just headphone amplifiers?
Yeah, that's the other thing we have to do. Mm-hmm. The amplifier, the headphone thing is good, but I think we have to have more space.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah,
that's right.
Mm. So we are Sunday morning, so it is still very early to do a full debrief. So can you give us some figure about the attendance of the visitors so far?
Yeah, it's very easy. Yesterday night we had almost 4,000 people visiting two days, and I hope till the end of the day it's going to be 5,000. And if we get the 5,000, we're going to open up the champagne bottle.
Okay.
Yeah, because what I said, it's 5,000 people interested in guitars. Mm-hmm. It's not 5,000 people visiting. Okay, we have to. I saw a little child now, so it's one less.
Yeah.
but no, not joking. It's really people interested in guitars, and that makes me happy.
Yeah, because you have to pay. It's not very expensive. It's just as you say, 18 euro to come in. So it means that the people who are there are really qualified, targeted audience. So it's not. It's very cheap for what you can see, all the exhibitors, the shows, the masterclasses, and everything. So it's good. So economically, I guess it makes sense. You think there will be a 2018 edition?
I'm sure.
Okay,
I'm
great.
Sure.
Excellent.
I'm sure.
Okay.
And you mentioned that it's not expensive. The other thing, it's not expensive for the exhibitors too, because they don't have to have big booths. Mm-hmm. They can do it. You know, this venue is so great. Mm-hmm. Like in the first floor, you don't have to have anything. Just bring your few guitars, some stuff, and then you're done.
Yeah.
You don't have to bring lights. You don't have to bring carpet. Mm-hmm. It's already done.
Mm-hmm. What is the message you would like to send to the future exhibitor? Or maybe the people who say, well, you know what, Dieter, this sounds good, but maybe next year. So what do you say to them?
I say, if you have been here and have seen it, you have to come. If you haven't been here, ask the other guys. Ask the other guy how it was. And I haven't seen so many smiling faces since a couple of years.
Mm.
Because then there's another thing. Some people ask me why do you do it in Mannheim?
Mm?
Because
yeah.
Mannheim is not the famous city in Germany. They have lots of inventors, by the way. Fred Gretsch is from here.
Okay.
He was born here. The old Fred Gretsch was born here. They invented the bicycle here. They invented the motor.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a musical city. It's a UNESCO city of music. They have a big academy for music. And the other thing is, we have at the NAMM show in the United States, the hotels are really close. The hotels are not expensive. There's it's close to the main station.
Yeah, yeah.
We have lots of restaurants, and they're not expensive, and you don't have to fight for a table.
Yeah.
So to the exhibitors who are not here, there's lots of positive things here.
Yeah, I agree with that. And it's only a 3-hour train ride from Paris. So for me, it was a no-brainer to come. Yeah,
and if you arrive at Mannheim, it's 5 minutes walk to this place.
Yeah,
and it's in the middle of the city.
Mm.
And if you bring your wife, you can send her to the city shopping.
All right, Dieter, it was great to be able to have you on the show. So thank you very much. And again, congratulations for putting up this great show.
And I have to thank you that you came to Mannheim, that you made the big travel, and that you were part of it too, as the other ones.
Mm-hmm.
Because everybody's important.
All right.
Thank you
very
so much.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.